I've spoken to her briefly. She's obviously very disappointed with the decision and disappointed with the fact that Bobsleigh Canada continues to act in such a grossly unsportsmanlike fashion with regard to her release to compete for the United States. I think the board of directors of Canada Bobsleigh should be ashamed of themselves and they should all resign. I mean, the way that they've treated a national treasure has just been completely, as far as I'm concerned, beyond the pale. There's a number of discrepancies. We're also going to be filing an appeal of their findings with regard to this, their so-called harassment investigation. Key witnesses that Kaillie identified to support her claims refused to testify. We're obviously not giving up the fight, and we're continuing to move forward. And one of the things that that we'll be looking at is the fact that that Bobsleigh Canada's legal counsel, made a number of concessions in court, including that she's not, contrary to the judge's decision, she's not a carded athlete. She's not currently under contract to Bobsleigh Canada, and that the very reason for having releases is to prevent athletes from switching teams during the season. So it may well be that we can prevail upon the International Bobsleigh Federation to allow her to compete for the United States absent a release, given how unreasonable and how unsportsmanlike Bobsleigh Canada is behaving.
I thought it was a very fair-minded decision. I think Justice Anderson considered all of the material before her. She considered the proper test, and it was obvious that she had spent a lot of time through Mr. Sorensen's affidavit and considered all of the impacts of this decision, not only on Ms. Humphries and BCS, but also sport in general.
Our mandate is to develop World Olympic champions. This is what we do. Kaillie is obviously a World Olympic champion. We want Kaillie in our program. Kaillie is obviously going to be a threat in the next Olympics, and there's nothing more that we like to see other than Canadians standing on the podium. Hopefully we can get into another scenario where we have some constructive discussions about how we might be able to move forward with that. We've taken these allegations seriously, and we've looked into every aspect of our programs, and we believe we have a safe and a high-performing training environment for all athletes.